Alright, people, welcome back. More DM Duel Commentary. So, we are joined by Stu.
What's up, guys?
And we have something interesting here. So, more lower rated person, which is fine. You have Chaos Theory 755 and only 195 playing the Melodious. And already got the Aria play out. So, that's proud.
Dang.
Damn. And then bust out the Elegy too. Like, alright, how about you just do nothing?
So the like drop this whole hand turn one.
Hey, I mean, lock it down. His monsters can't be destroyed by card effect, cannot be targeted, and cannot be destroyed by battle. Like, wow. Versus Shannon 23 here at 1,069 with 5,000 experience. So
exactly 5,000. Wow.
Mm-hmm. So let's see how Shannon is going to get out of this, because, God, I mean, that's power. Just lock it down. Oh.
Dang.
Ignite and reload. All right.
It's like tier three decks going on here.
Mm-hmm. I still like that card. So.
Oh, we still don't know if it's actual Ignites, though.
No, we still don't.
I just saw Ignites and thought it was just Ignites.
Mm-hmm. Any Pendulum-based deck can play it. This card's so good. Like, when Cleese got hit and I was still trying, I was like, oh yeah, Ignite reload's so good. get that shuffle back and that plus one. Like, so good. The only reason why Ignites don't play is because you cannot draw cards by card effects the rest of the turn. So Ignites are like, no, I'm too good with my Royal Magical Library. Sack the crap out of you. So I don't want to play my own card.
For some reason, that still isn't banned.
Yep. I guess they were like, oh, we solved the sackiness by banning Chicken Game. So you don't have to worry anymore, people.
Well, that was very good. I assumed he drew into that, maybe.
Maybe.
See, if he opened it and then he got the upstart in that, so.
Mm-hmm.
Compliments to the number generator.
So, guess we'll do some small talk. How you been lately, Stu?
I've been good.
You're really good. Your channel just exploded.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, I remember when Stu was like 1K ahead of me. Now this man's like going on like 5K. I'm like, what the hell? That's not fair.
Yeah, I'm sorry, man.
It's like, God damn it.
Hey, when that league goes up, I'll make sure to promote it as good as I can.
Because you're in it.
Oh, of course. Even if I wasn't in it.
Okay.
Some good entertainment.
Well, I got plans to make my channel bigger. I'm going to probably Thursday, if I'm not busy, I'll try to, no, I might be busy. I don't know. I want to do the Mega Capital G plan.
Oh, yeah, you're subscribed to him on Twitch, right?
Yeah. So pretty much the idea is that I'm going to hit him up with that 2 months, because I've been subscribed 2 months, so then he'll recognize me. And then I'm going to hit him up. I've been saving up on PayPal for my YouTube channel. I'm going to hit him up. I'm going to give him $30, and I'm going to be like, drop me in this fucking Skype
Dang.
Call.
Yeah,
drop me in the Skype call. And then I'm pretty much pissed the idea that he needs a co-host. And then hopefully I can become the co-host of his streams, and then that'll make me popular.
That's a great plan you got there.
And then when I get a little bit bigger, then I'm going to try to get some more tag partners and smaller Yu-Gi-Tubers that are consistent and work hard to join me as more tag partners and, of course, Yu-Gi-Oh! Tier Draft League. So I can up them. But, that pendulum sound. That's nice and all, but where are you going with this? Like, his monsters cannot be destroyed by battle, cannot be destroyed by card effect, and cannot be targeted. Like, that's too much power. Right?
Just have fun.
Like, do you?
If only you had Luster, you can go into the Ignister and spin it, but...
Yeah, that would help.
Don't really know how you're gonna get out of this situation.
Okay. So, sync 7 into... Meteor Burst, alright. There's someone talking about blah blah blah. So is it like monster effects can't be activated during the battle phase or something?
What, on the Meteor Burst?
Yeah. Monsters in your opponent's position cannot activate their effects during the battle phase. Yeah, but.
Do those activate, though?
Those are all continuous.
Yeah, so. Sorry, man. Both these guys are dropping their entire hand first turn.
Mm-hmm. Just going ham, and then just end your turn. Did he say the effect of a paladin? I guess he did. I'm assuming he did. Alright, go ahead and get that luster. Yep, it's time. Next turn, Ignister.
Yeah, because you have to announce that guy's effect on summon just like the Magi Specter cat.
Yeah. Discard spell, summon all fairy type monsters you control, gain 300 attack, 500 attack. So, all fairy type monsters you control, gain 500 attack and defense. Alright. So they're all pretty beefy right now, right? I don't know where he's getting this 1300. Unless I'm missing something. I only see 800.
Yeah, 500 plus 300
Yeah.
equals 800, right? Maybe he thinks that the other one in the middle gains him like 500 or something.
No, Arya does enough. She special summon and
Yeah.
can target or destroy them by battle. That's crazy. It's like, oh, well, I hope I get Regeki, and then you just bust out Elegy too. And it's like, oh, shit. But when you hit him with that Ignister, then he'll be in some deep shit. Because all I have to do is just summon Ignister, hit up that fucking Arya, gone, doesn't target. And then now you can't be destroyed by card effect? That's fine, I'll just run your ass over. Yeah, I'm kind of lost on an attack. This card is about to summon all fairy type monsters you control gain 300 attack. And this one says, while the special card gonna fail, all fairy type monsters gain 500 attack. Like, is it for each, or am I missing something? I'm so lost. Where's this 1300?
No one even knows how to do the math or anything.
Yeah, there's like no one doing the math. Like, okay.
Okay, finally. Oh no, we got the cyber bully in here, guys.
Oh no. I never really understood cyberbullying.
I know there's just this one big YouTuber that does like talks about it and stuff. He like makes fun of it, but just seems stupid. Just
I mean, I
turn
wouldn't.
off your computer
Yeah,
then.
I'd say I wouldn't say it's a matter of that importance. Just walk away, step away from your computer. Like, it's not like real life bullying where, you know, you're placed in a situation you can't get out of. Like, oh, he's a bully in my class and I see him every day. Like, you could just get away from the computer, not get onto anything that the bully's there, but I guess then you're feeling like you're letting the bully win.
I mean, what else are you gonna do? If
I don't know.
you're that offended by it, then I guess he does win. I don't know.
I'm so lost what's happening right now.
Yeah. He hasn't pendulum, so you know he's gonna do that eventually. And then I would assume after he goes for that, he'll go Ignister and then attempt to win the duel. Don't really know why he played Valhalla, though.
Yeah, chaos, like, what's the
That
point of
was just
that?
pretty pointless.
Like, if it doesn't need to be played, don't play it. Like, you're just revealing cards that you have in your hand for no reason. It's not doesn't do any deck thinning, you're not building up resources, you just play it just to play it. All right. Hit him with that Ignister. You got that effect veiler? Yep.
Oh, that would suck.
Yep, gone.
Dang, that premium gold puts in so much work. Not even a dollar now?
Yep.
I remember that was like $20. Really? Question
I can't
mark?
see the glow. I don't understand. I can't be targeted. I'm not targeting you. Question mark.
Oh, they better not get into that argument. They better not. No!
Doesn't target.
Come on, guys.
Ignis, you're too strong. Hit you up with that tiramisu. Gone. And I definitely can confirm for Yu-Gi-Oh! Teardraft League Season 2 that Madoche's is not Tier 3. It's tier 2.
Oh yeah. What about Magi
Tier
Specters?
2.
Oh, okay.
Oh no, look at you're fucking prying information out of
It's not
me.
like I thought I was going to use that as my tier 3 deck. No, I wasn't.
You're prying information out of me. No. So we got a cool minute. Because I want to get more people, some smaller people out there who work really hard. So I'll probably do like people who upload fairly consistently that have like less than 2,000 subs.
No, that seemed fair. Mm-hmm. Just the problem of actually getting in touch with them and then.
Well, hopefully,
and stuff. Well,
hopefully through Mega Capital G, I'll get big enough to where I can actually do things. Like, I, for goodness sake. And I'll probably make some restriction. Like, you have to be YugiTubing for, like, at least, like, like 6 months. Because I know there's going to be a ton of people that would just be like, oh, I'm a YugiTuber now. I just made this channel.
Mom, I'm a YugiTuber. I just woke up one morning, made my channel. Hey, I'm a YugiTuber.
So I'm going to be like, no. Like, you gotta have to like, put some effort into the channel previous to me making this announcement in Yu-Gi-Oh! 2 Draft League. Unless stated otherwise.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
But generally, that's gonna be the consensus. So now since that Aria is gone, the struggle is gonna be real. Like,
this turn's just been going on forever.
Mm-hmm. Another one. Hard.
Oh yeah.
You like Meteor? All right, so Meteor can attack, right? Oh, but it doesn't matter because I guess you're just gonna go in Absolute. Big Eye? Flare?
Dracosack.
Oh, no, Dracosack. It's been a cool minute. All right, Absolute, that's what I... It's been a cool minute since anybody's went to Dracosack. It's just not that good anymore because freaking Castell handled it so easily.
Yeah, I know.
Even when 101 came out, you're like, all right, I'll just put the Dracosack in defense then. I'm good. And Castell's like,
and it destroys and it targets.
Mm-hmm.
It's like targeting and destroying isn't that good anymore.
All right, so Absolute will then block its own attack. Hello?
Yeah, I don't know how that went to the hand.
Yeah, like, why
yeah, I know, right? Probably not going to be game this turn since he upstarted him.
Yeah.
It'd be close, though.
That's a scary field, though. Vortex wasn't summoned. That's only when Vortex is summoned.
He just read the first sentence. He's like, oh, it goes to my hand, guys.
No, Vortex has been there. I don't know how many extra deck monsters. You just block the attack, so. Okay, man, never mind. He's just gonna hit the B. He's like, fuck it, it's too complicated. So you had a little bit of. Oh, damn.
Oh, really, man?
Oh, that sucks. Alright, I guess we'll just get a different duel.
Yeah, get
Hello,
another duel.
Shannon! Calm Cyberbully. Down!
Oh, no.
Cyberbully, tell Shannon to calm down.
What's the point of saying that if he already left? You're just saying that to all the watchers then?
Yeah, no.
It's like, look at how cool I am. He's a retard.
We are back. Alright.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I think Cyberbully's a fan of yours.
Yeah, you're probably going to see the same guys come in here.
Yeah, they're just like, oh, Susan, gotta follow.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I haven't seen this in a cool minute. We got Depremacy at only 180, which is fine. And we got Smelly Sandgan. That's kind of insulting.
Oh, wow.
861. Fighting that ape fighter.
Take a shower, Sandkin.
There's like...
Why are there like six people watching this?
Famous.
Oh, of course,
I'm not
guys. Famous.
You're Stu's famous. He's becoming a medium YugiTuber. I'm like, oh no, he's leaving us small people behind. He's almost at like 5K.
Hey, back in the day, if you were considered small, it was below you had 1,000 subscribers.
I'd say you're medium now. You're going to medium. You're getting up there with like the...
My lifetime goal is just to get 10K subs, and then after that, I don't care what happens.
Damn, I don't care what happens.
Yeah.
I would love 10K subs.
Oh, I would love that too.
Like half the subscribers that fucking Mega Capital G or Vexicus is one of the bigger half. Yeah, you need to get bigger like SEMO or who's another person who grew really big really quick. Oh, Cali Effect. I guess Yugimation. At least what Yugimation does is special.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't want you to get that spell card. Or that trap card. They're probably that spell card that
So they can
pandemic.
like Dark Hole it on your next turn or
Yeah,
something.
it's gonna hit you with the Sergeki right now.
I guess he drew into the Veiler because you probably would have Veilered Rabbit.
Oh. Okay. That's
Haven't seen that since Dragon
yeah.
Rulers.
That's one way to handle off you.
Yeah, when I played Evilswarms against Dragon Rulers, they always sided that stupid card against me.
Yep. And it's a fire for their blaster too.
Yup.
All right, that works.
Still have no idea what he's
But
playing.
we don't need to worry about it. Apparently, just because you're here, this is low-rated duelist.
I was just about to say, watch him have the Kirkion.
No, you should at least let him pay costs.
Yeah, that was a pretty bad misplay. Now if he has another one, he could just like summon it. I mean, he's probably gonna win
Yeah,
anyway.
and catch his Galaxy Cyclone. Yo. You want a bottom? You didn't want a bottomless that Kirkion? I would have
Wow.
hella bottomless that Kirkion. And if he had the pandemic, oh well. At least he played it. You had to get rid of it soon.
Bigger question is why he didn't play the Cyclone first.
Yeah, I don't know why he did. Damn.
Dang, the
No.
disrespect.
You're not gonna make any ring for plays off of him. Okay.
Oh, he drew into the card he needed off that. That's why Dark Bribe sucks, guys.
Yeah. They just draw into that next card, like, ugh. And for goodness sakes, we upstart so good you get to see the next card. You're purposely letting them see that next card. Sure, you get to negate something, but they get to look at that next card.
All these limited cards. You got the Raigeki, then the Rabbit, then the Mind Control.
You're
Like,
like the last
dang.
person that should be surprised. You'd be sending me screenshots of the number.
Yeah, I know.
You're like,
That was crazy, that one duel I
you're like,
did.
what the fuck? Yeah.
Oh, that clutch
Go
50.
ahead and do it. I know you have him in your extra deck. Come on. Come on. Main phase two. Make him.
I've actually seen some people take Cowboy out of their extra deck now.
Yeah. He's fallen. He's definitely falling. It's like you have your Castell and your wow, ballsy. You have your Castell, your Dweller,
Dang the
your
luck.
Dark Rebellion, your Wrath. Yeah, there's a lot of cards that are above him now. Then you got.
Why would you tell him that? You're giving him the
I know.
idea.
Why the hell?
He might have forgot.
You could have lived for a turn. Ah! Then you got Diamond Dyer, Emerald, Utopia, and Utopia the Lightning. See?
Heartland Draco.
I think Heartland Draco is probably even lower than freaking
Yeah, well, he's one of my favorites.
Who else? I feel like I'm missing someone. Rhapsody even kind of fell off, too.
Oh yeah, which one's that
The
again?
one that detaches the.
Oh, the banish equip
Yeah.
guy. Yeah, no one plays that
No.
anymore. Same thing with Ragnar Zero, that used to be a
Yeah,
staple.
that's gone. Yeah. So.
See if he has the third and final Fire Ferret.
So there's a lot of stuff to fill in, despite Exiton and the Lava Chain being gone. And Shockmaster.
Oh yeah, it's probably one of the reasons why people want the extra deck to go to 20.
No.
I think Kunami's too lazy to make that a rule.
We drove by the freaking Konami building yesterday in Vegas.
Wait, there's a Kunami building in
It's right across
Vegas?
from the airport. Right across the street.
Oh wow.
It just drove by and just like, fuck you.
Should have just TP'd the whole place.
They're really condescending. Like, the building is just covered with the word Konami. Like, all over the place. It's like, really? Like, yes. I was like, I wonder what building
Is that where they
that
make Yu-Gi-Oh
is.
cards?
Konami, Konami,
It's
Konami, Konami, Konami. I'm like, wow.
totally not Konami, guys.
It's the devil.
Yeah,
What? That's a set bottomless. How? Well, I guess at least next turn you can get rid of that Necro Valley. Not that it really.
no, you can't. Can't banish it from
Oh
the
yeah, and you
grave.
just can't banish, period, right? Cards in either player's graveyard cannot be banished. Damn. Not that it really affects him.
Ouch.
Unless he has, like, Rabbit or something.
Don't even know if he's playing Gravekeepers. We haven't even seen one Gravekeeper.
I don't think so. I think he's just playing Necro Valley because Necro Valley is such a good card.
I guess. I mean, so it's like anti-meta with Fire Ferrets or something. Best deck ever.
Just cards to try to get the one up on your opponent. Some Suiciders, like Ferret, and your Trap Tricks. Get some back row. Just stay one up on your opponent, I guess.
Really got to announce that you're detaching?
No. You never. You know detaching is cost. So no, you don't announce that you're detaching. It's not like it starts a chain. It's like, hey, I'm going to detach. Do you want to respond? You can respond after it's detached for cost, but whatever.
Hey, I bet that's the pandemic set, guys. Just a wild guess.
Maybe he is actually playing some Gravekeepers, or maybe just running Commander to increase the consistency of getting your Necro Valley. You think that's Ferret?
Probably. It's either that or Gravekeeper Spy. He gets Rota again.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. So if he's smart, he'll probably make a Dweller.
Yeah, that'd be smart. Or that.
Have you seen the price of the Ultimate Rare Lures? Mm-hmm. Still so much money. Like, just because it went to 1 to 2 doesn't, like, quadruple its price.
You can get two of them, so you're like, oh, everybody has one, probably wants a second one, so we'll just hike the price up and make money. This is Yu-Gi-Oh! It's all about the money.
I guess.
You can't play Yu-Gi-Oh! If you don't have any money. Or, well, you can, you're just not gonna win.
Okay, you could just go to Walmart.
Yeah, true.
Buy three structure decks, and then I win.
Nope.
One day of peace. Wow.
Go ahead and say it.
One day of pizza.
What? He got that card too? That card's awesome. Ah. Evilswarms. Just in case you think you're... Oh, well. Just in case you think that you're going to make, like, a rank 4 to handle Ophion. Like, nope. Alright.
So I guess who needs Twin Twister?
Twin Twister
must be a big fan of...
Ah, Soul Drain.
Why would you side that in against Evilswarms?
Maybe he named Exit.
Then why wouldn't you side it out?
He doesn't have a side neck. And it was the Ferret. Ah. Wow.
Oh, yeah. Of course it was.
Ferret too strong, man. Okay.
Well, that card's not that bad.
Summon them Heliotropes. Are you actually playing, like, some dinos or something? No? Alright, just Heliotrope.
Oh, I remember when Evilswarms first came out. There was the Dino Rabbit Evilswarm deck. That was fun.
Back when Yu-Gi-Oh! Was not as fast.
Yeah, pretty much. There's also a Fire Fist Dino Rabbit.
Mm-hmm.
Play the two rabbits for the Genie Warped Werewolves.
Damn, that struggle. Your beater deck is getting outbeaten. Destroys monster by battle. If only you could have destroyed something by battle, you could have went up by 300.
You just now realized that.
You got anything? And even if you do, probably have something. Ooh, during the damage step?
Oh,
damn.
Oh,
wow.
What is this, TG stun now?
That Horn of the Phantom Beast. Damn. Wreck his booty. Draw a card.
Yeah, whenever you can resolve that, it's going to put in work. Now we might go into game number 3.
He goes up by 800, so he goes with 27, then he activates the effect. So he's 3,000 right now? Damn. Damn. Yeah, we might go to game three. That horn, though. I like how he's playing ball. Crap. 1950. Attack? Ah, nope. Yep, and he is free from Kaiser Coliseum.
Oh, maybe it's a Beast Warrior deck.
Maybe.
That just texts in a whole bunch of random floodgates.
So I guess everybody's just gonna forget about that 300.
Yeah, pretty much. That's the second time he's blind allured in this match.
Pitch your hand. Yep.
Yes! That's what you get, man. You got lucky that first time.
Don't want to talk about it on Daily Duels. That was you see that episode?
No,
One
what
day I was
happened?
playing a guy, he had no cards. He went alert, draw two, and then he didn't draw dark, but he drew Mizuki, so he just sent Mizuki and revived something. You
Oh,
dick! Who told you could do that?
it's like drawing two, and then you draw into like a dandy and a gulp bowl, be like, oh,
Yeah, like,
thanks.
ah.
Yeah.
All right. GG. Wow. You usually don't say GG until the match is over. All right. All right, game three. This is what you guys been waiting for.
Okay, so he only says GG when he wins. He didn't say it after the
Yeah,
first
true.
game. It's only a good game if I win, guys. Remember that. Think he's gonna add the bottomless.
I'm kind of wondering if there's any other trap holes in there besides bottomless.
Yeah, I have no idea. Oh, it is a beast deck, I knew it.
Okay. Well, at least it's not monarchs or PK Fire or monarchs or cosmos or monarchs or monarchs or monarchs. Fucking monarchs.
It's like 1 week it's no extra deck monarchs, the next week it's extra deck monarchs. You can't escape it. I remember when Tengu used to be like the best card ever.
Hey, I'm smelling. Nice amount of back row you got there. It'd be a shame if he hit you with Tone Twister. Too bad he only plays skeletons.
I know, right?
Wow. Yeah, that works. Haven't seen that card in a while.
Yep, that errata pretty much made it terrible.
Look at that.
And with the release of Solemn Strike.
Look at that. You used Galaxy Cyclones when a Twin Twister could have handled that.
Still would have been two cards for two
True.
cards, though.
But now he has two Galaxy Cyclones in the grave. You just gotta hope he doesn't get that Necro Valley. Ah, run again.
All three games, of course. You sure it's not a three?
I wish I was at three. No, I don't. Because it would be hella OP right now. Freaking PK Fire and Monarchs. Hell no.
Oh, yeah.
What about him?
Effect
Yeah,
doesn't
I say, what
activate.
about him? Caster, yes, that is a caster. Well, I was to say, you might be careful. He might have another black horn. I've seen that played in the pool.
Yeah, which is actually a pretty good card in this matchup.
I play Solemn Strike, even though it's free on here. You could just play black horn.
There's some guys that only play with cards they own in real life.
Ah!
Oh, wow. Duel's so predictable.
Ah!
Dang!
It's Norton. What's wrong with it?
For a second there, I thought it was at one. I was like, wow, I got the limited instant fusion. Then I was like, oh, yeah, it's still not at
He's
one.
got that limited Norton.
Of
You can
course.
lie. So disgusting. It's like cancer. And like none of the meta decks play him either, so that doesn't help.
Yeah, unless you're playing like extra deck monarchs, none of the good decks play it.
Oh yeah, they do play instant fusion.
Yeah, they play a brilliant fusion, instant fusion, all the fusions.
You going into? All right. Ah, no.
if only you could activate the effect and make MST target MST.
So you got nothing to say about that?
Oh, emptiness, of course. Oh my god.
Yep. Caster. Do you select the monster that's destroyed by the ferret, or... Oh, it's just Tengu. Alright, Tengu floaty time. Oh shit. Smelly has a level 4 in his hand. He might be able to turn this duel around. Just float off your Tengu, summon another level 4, go into, like, Dark Rebellion.
Or 101. Not Castell, because Castell would be bad. I forgot what Nimble Mom Manga does.
You destroy a battle, you summon another copy, and you gain 1,000 life points.
Unfortunately, he doesn't have a rank level 4.
Yeah,
but he does!
That game, getting close to it. I'm just gonna go Nofion, because why not? Damn.
Yep, Fion had Pandemic.
He withdraw level 4, he could have got back into the game.
That's what I hate when games come down to that, especially game 3s. It's like, I would have won if I drew that.
I tried to channel my skill, but my luck wouldn't let me. I wonder what it could be. So even if you top deck Regeki, not sure if you're playing it. Okay.
Might be Mirror Force.
Still got the Pandemic. Alright.
Or not.
Alright, it's over, people.
Better than Monarchs, of course.
At least it wasn't Monarchs.
Yeah, at least he won one game.
Alright, so I hope that you guys enjoyed. Thank you, Stu, for joining me. And I'll
see
you guys next week with some more Duel commentary. Alright, people. Thanks for watching.